Hey folks, let me go over a little bit on what I'm doing with this AC here. The issue I have right now is because of the distance up and down in the window, I am unable to use the regular guide piece that keeps it from tipping too far out the window. So what I've done is a couple of things. The first thing I did is to get the right, so measure the distance, the gap, and I have two pieces of wood. And what they are going to do is each piece is going to be extended all the way out on the side. That will help give me a base for this piece. What this is going to do, once this is attached in, this will act as this piece here. Now the reason it has to be this much longer is I don't have a top piece in the back in the center like you normally would for this to rest against. And I've made this wide and as long as I could to give it as much strength as I can when resting against this. So this is going to be the first step. And then I will show you the reinforcing that I'm going to do also. All right, what I did to create this piece to replace this here, there's three pre-drilled holes in the top of the AC designed for this attachment. Again, this is too tall. What I did is I measured the distance from here to the edge to line this up. And then all I really needed to do was use the distance I measured from here onto this and then set this on top, mark the three holes. I drilled them enough so the screws will go down through on their own without using the wood to catch, and then did a countersink because I cannot go any higher than this, and I don't believe it will slide in. The reason I'm having trouble sliding in and out is that there's underneath where you can't see, there's a little bit of a hump build on this, so I kind of have to wiggle this in and out. So I'm going to attach this top piece. Now, because I'm countersinking, I can't use the regular nut driver. All right, when I did the countersink, I wanted to give it enough, leave enough here for the wood to, the screw to hold on to the wood. All right, so let's get this set up to slide in the window. The other reason I'm doing all this is I'm trying to make it, you know, semi-permanent so it can even stay in going down the road. Because these things are bulky, they're heavy, it's really something I didn't want to fight to put in and out of the window all the time. That's actually really good where that is. I know it's not perfect. All right, now most ACs, there's some speculation on this as to whether or not or how much they need to be tilted. The last thing you want is when it's running is for water to drain in. That would be definitely not a good thing. So what I've done is when I had it in the window the first time, the top part was definitely tilted in towards the inside of the bus. So I did a couple checks. I've made a couple measurements and cuts along these here. And now I'm going to put this in and recheck the AC unit in the window. All right, so this is what it's going to look like hanging outside the window. Now, a couple things going down the road. I'm pretty sure I will want something on the side just to keep stuff from flying in the vents there. So I'll have to figure that out at some point. I don't think it'd be too difficult to make a panel for that. And right now, this is what the AC looks like on the inside. I will need to do a couple of panels on either side to close in the gaps and give a little bit more support to this holding in the window. It's doing pretty good right now, but going down the road, you definitely want that to be secure.